Did the best sounding portable speaker just get better? Say hello to the Bose Soundlink Flex 2, a speaker that you guys have been very keen for us to take a closer look at. But are the seemingly minor upgrades really that significant to warrant a brand new generation? Let's find out. Now, at a glance, you'd be forgiven for thinking that nothing's really changed in comparison to the original Soundlink Flex, and well, it hasn't really, at least not on the outside anyway. But I guess, as the saying goes, if it ain't broke, then don't fix it. So we've still got that classic pill-shaped design consisting of a front metal grille and a silicone rubber rear and top with a little utility loop on the side. Now, on top is where we find our controls consisting of power, Bluetooth, play pause, and volume controls, and new with the Soundlink Flex 2, a shortcut button that can be used to either begin playing music from your linked Spotify account, access your voice assistant, or put the speaker into stereo pairing mode if you or a friend have another one. Now, longtime subscribers of this channel will know that we've been using the original Soundlink Flex over the last couple of years or so, and it's been well and truly put through its paces. So we have complete confidence in the durability of this particular design and choice of materials. Now, the only thing I would mention though is that because this exposed grille is metal, it will mark quite easily if you drop it face down, so it will show signs of wear and tear a little bit easier than other options on the market, which is just something to bear in mind. Okay, so not much has changed from a design perspective then, but what about the features? Well, we've still got the same 12-hour battery life and 4-hour recharge time via USB-C, built-in microphone for calls and position IQ technology that we benefited from in the original, along with multi-point connection, meaning that you can connect more than one device at the same time. And this one still retains the ability to connect to a number of other Bose products, including soundbars. So you've got the option to have the same audio playing from both the speaker and a compatible Bose device. Now, as far as portables go, I'd say it offers all of your must-haves when it comes to features, but I would have liked to have seen those battery numbers improved, especially when you consider the likes of the Marshall Emberton 3 that can last for up to 32 hours from a 2-hour recharge time. We now also step up from Bluetooth 4.2 to Bluetooth 5.3 for improved connectivity and benefit from the addition of Snapdragon sound technology that optimizes Qualcomm technologies to ensure the best sound quality, connection stability, and latency for streaming. Of course, you will need a Snapdragon sound certified device to experience this, such as a compatible Android device. So us iPhone users will miss out on this, but that's a big tick in the box if you're someone who would benefit from this. Now, arguably, one of the biggest changes this time around is that we finally have the ability to adjust the EQ of this speaker in the companion app, along with some other in-app functionality, which will be a game changer for some of you guys out there. Now, those of you who owned the original Soundlink Flex will remember that the app experience was very limited. In fact, adjusting the volume was the only really sound-related functionality that we had available to us, so the addition of an EQ is very welcomed in this latest iteration. So in the app, we can check the battery life, we can adjust volume, select between our sources, adjust that shortcut button functionality that I mentioned a little bit earlier, view tips, and of course, adjust the EQ. So we've got 4 different presets that we can quickly select between and an EQ slider consisting of bass, mids, and treble that we can use to really fine-tune the sound performance. Now, I quite like the sound performance straight out of the box, but having the ability to fine-tune the EQ to create a custom sound profile to your particular preference is always a nice option to have. On to the part that we're all desperate for then, the sound performance. Now, the original Soundlink Flex offered what was arguably the best sound profile from a portable speaker when it was released a few years ago. So naturally, we've been very excited to put this new one through its paces. Now, as far as we can tell, there hasn't really been any significant upgrades to the actual internals of this one versus its predecessor. And if there has been, Bose haven't really shouted about it. Now, we did try on multiple occasions to reach out to Bose regarding the internal makeup of this one, but I think it's fair to say that we haven't really had too much clarity from them on this matter. Either way, rather than get caught up in the technicalities, we prefer to let you guys make your own minds up on the performance of this one. So let's give you all a quick listen now. Oh, and usual disclaimer that what you hear over YouTube won't be exactly what I'm hearing right here in our studio, but it should give you a good idea as to how this one sounds.
Like a fire without.
So hopefully you guys enjoyed that little test. Make sure you let me know what you thought of it down in the comments below. Now for me, it comes as no surprise that it sounds great. Sure, it might not necessarily be the loudest or the most powerful portable option, but what it lacks in overall oomph, it more than makes up for in pure sound quality. Now I won't be drawing comparisons between other portables in this video, but rest assured, our latest portable speaker buying guide is on the way very soon, where Al and I will be putting the best portable options head to head across a variety of categories, including sound performance. So make sure that you guys stay tuned for that one. But for now, let's dive a little deeper on the performance of the Soundlink Flex 2. It's a warm sounding, bright, well-balanced speaker that I've been really impressed with in testing over the last few weeks. It offers great separation between the layers with particularly impressive vocal clarity and the ability to highlight the details and nuances of a song over other portables on the market. The low-end performance is also noteworthy. Again, it's not the most punchy or impactful, but rather offers up a clean, tidy, controlled bass performance. I also felt as though those EQ adjustments and presets did make a noticeable difference to the sound signature of the speaker, especially with the mids and treble, which hopefully translated across in the sound tests. Don't get me wrong, I think it sounds great out of the box, but it's nice to have the ability to squeeze a little more out of it. And regardless of how hard I pushed it in either direction, I didn't notice the speaker start to suffer or fall apart. The vocals remained clear and undistorted, and the bass didn't become muddied either. Now, no, it isn't going to replace your hi-fi setup anytime soon, but considering the form factor and price tag, I do think you'd be hard pushed to find something that could really rival this one on pure sound quality alone. And the fact that you could also stereo pair two of these for an even wider soundstage is also definitely something worth taking into consideration. Okay, so what are my final thoughts on this one then? And do I think it's one worth considering? Well, to be honest, if you're the sort of person who prioritizes sound performance from your portable over everything else, then look no further. The Soundlink Flex 2 is right up there as one of the best portable speakers that we've tested in terms of pure sound performance alone, and I don't think you'll be left wanting more. The addition of that in-app EQ and ability to fine-tune the sound signature is something that we've all been crying out for ever since the release of the first gen all those years ago. And although there might not be a wealth of new upgrades, for a lot of people, that won't matter as long as it sounds great. But I do think that that's the only category that this one wins out in. As someone like me who loves a day trip to the beach, weekends away camping, or providing the soundtrack to parties, my portable priorities just simply don't align with the Soundlink Flex 2 as much as they do with other options on the market. Of course, I want something that sounds good, but for me, that's not the be all and end all. I want something that I can throw around all day, not have to worry about dying on me halfway through a weekend long trip. And for that reason, I'm drawn more towards something like the rugged Marshall Emberton 3 for its quicker recharge time and longer battery life, along with the usefulness of that battery life indicator. Now, does that mean this is a bad choice? No. I think it's just really important that you consider your own priorities, as the portable speaker market is full of so many great options that might tick other boxes more convincingly than this one does. But what about if you're already an owner of the original Soundlink Flex? Well, in that case, I think you really need to weigh up if you're actually going to benefit from the incremental upgrades on offer in this latest version. This isn't a cheap option, so you just really need to question whether something like the adjustable EQ alone is worth the upgrade for you. Personally, I just can't help but feel slightly disappointed that we haven't seen more improvements and upgrades over the previous iteration, but either way, make sure you guys let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Hopefully you all enjoyed this one, and I'll catch all of you in the next video.